Hello everyone, this is Rev Paul from Miracles One, and welcome to week 7 of our I Am Safe in God healing journey and building our miracle toolboxes this year. Today's topic is on the idea of performing miracles. One of the things that as I was working with Jesus this week on preparing for this discussion, I got a vision of a telescoping mirror. A telescoping mirror is going to be our tool analogy for a miracle toolbox this week. And I was like, why in the heck are you showing me a telescoping mirror? And if you'll recall from last week's discussion, one of the ideas that Jesus wanted to drive home with that hammer and nail into our heads is that we were created perfect by God. He wants to continue to reinforce that idea, help us to continue to allow that to soak within our minds and to really begin to truly accept that truth about us, because it is a core key foundation needed in order for us to become miracle workers for Him. So I'm like, well, what about this mirror? He says, well, a telescoping mirror is it has a handle and it telescopes out and has a mirror on it, and you use it to look around underneath engine parts, you know, underneath the engine compartment within a car, for example. And he said, well, think about your brother and your sisters within the world, okay? And he says, when you look at your brother and sister, he says, just imagine that you're taking that telescoping mirror and you're putting it around behind their head, and then you see the reflection of the mirror coming back at you. He's like, are you seeing a dirty rat, or are you seeing the Christ, the Holy Son of God Himself? Are you seeing that holy, created, perfect spiritual being that God created whenever that happened, okay? And actually, I have a picture of this for you today, so I wanted to share that with you because I thought it was pretty funny. So there is your telescoping mirror, and it has a little dirty rat in there. So there's a little humor for us today from Jesus, helping us to catch ourselves when we have a grievance against another human being. That's the time that we need to stop ourselves and check in with Him to begin performing miracles and correcting our mind, letting the Holy Spirit help us to correct our mind, okay? It is key for us to remember that our brothers and sisters were created perfect by God. If we see them that way, then we're also remembering that is our true essence of who we are. And then he goes on, he's telling us that this is a key core foundation if we want to claim our inherent ability to become a miracle worker within the world. And I found this to be very exciting to read up on this stuff and to look at it, because Jesus is speaking very plainly and very clearly about our ability to perform miracles, either with His guidance or without His guidance. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in a little bit here. But let's go ahead and take a look at the text, chapter 1, section 3, titled Atonement and Miracles. He has some great little comments, I guess, or explanations on this idea of us being able to perform miracles and how this works. He's beginning to explain, how do we do it? How do we work with Him on it, okay? And if you take a look at paragraph 1, he says here, I'm going to read this right out of the course. Quote, as you share my unwillingness to accept error in yourself and others, you must join the great crusade to correct it. Listen to my voice and learn to undo error and to act to correct it. Okay? So once again, that reinforces that idea. We have to have this willingness to not see error in others. If we see error in others, that's a projection, and therefore we're seeing error in ourselves. When we're in that space, we're just bringing the blinders over, and we cannot begin to tap into that ability that we have to perform miracles, okay? So you've got to have that as a foundation. Remember who we are, who we truly are. Remember who everyone else truly is, okay? And he even says here in paragraph one that the power to work miracles belongs to you. That's me and you. He says here, I will provide the opportunities to perform these miracles, but you must be ready and willing. Doing them, actually performing miracles, will bring conviction in your ability to do them, because conviction comes through accomplishment. That is really cool stuff there if you think about it. He's very clearly saying, hey, you guys can do this. And a little bit later, he starts to explain how he's going to help us to do this, okay? That's pretty exciting. I don't know about you guys, but I would love to learn how to become a true miracle worker. That's why we picked up A Course in Miracles in the first place. I think a lot of us did. So what else does he have here? In paragraph four, he talks about asking him which miracles you should perform. So right here, he says, ask me which miracles you should perform. This spares you needless effort because you will be acting under direct communication. And he's talking about direct communication from him or direct communication from the Holy Spirit. In this context, he's talking very specifically about himself. The impersonal nature of the miracle is an essential ingredient because it enables him to direct its application. And under his, Jesus, guidance, miracles lead to the highly personal experience of revelation. All right. So he's saying very clearly here, he wants us, we have this ability to perform miracles because of who we are. However, he wants us to work with him on it. And the reason for that is we can make mistakes. We don't have to consult with him. We can actually, I guess we can figure out how to start performing miracles on our own and tapping into that ability, but we might make mistakes. It might delay things. And he wants it to be an efficient process to help us with our awakening, to help with the awakening of others, and to help with the contribution to the plan of atonement. All right, so he wants us to work with it. Going back to paragraph one, though, he says that he stands at the end of all of this. Let me go back up here. When you offer a miracle to any of my brothers and sisters, you do it to yourself, to ourselves, and to Jesus. The reason that you come before Jesus is he doesn't need miracles for this atonement process. But he stands at the end of it in case we fail temporarily, in case we make a mistake. That's actually really cool because it's giving us permission to go ahead and start trying to perform miracles and do the best that we can with them. And we don't have to worry about the mistakes. You know, we should call upon him for help, but he's basically giving us training wheels to begin learning how to perform miracles, okay? That's really cool. So don't be afraid to jump in and try to, you know, call upon him for help and to start trying to figure out how to do this, because he'll help, he'll make sure that he'll clean up the mistakes in the end, okay, while we're on our training wheels. That's really cool. So don't worry about it. Just kind of go for it. In paragraph eight, let's see here, I'm going to jump over to paragraph 8. He says, when practicing performing miracles, the idea is to have faith and trust the process. So we're practicing, and we're calling upon him to help us with performing miracles, we may not actually see things happening. And he's kind of indicating, don't worry about it, okay? That the miracles may have effects on your brothers that you may not recognize is not your concern. The miracle will always bless you, okay? Miracles you are not asked to perform have not lost their value. They are still expressions of your own state of grace, okay? So, a couple of things here. Don't worry about the results if you're practicing or trying to do miracles, and if you don't see anything happening, it doesn't necessarily mean that something is not happening. There could be a domino effect and that you're not even aware of. So have faith, trust the process, and your job is just to call for him and ask him to help you and to begin, you know, to practice it, to believe in it and practice it, okay? One of the things that you can do too, I think, while you're practicing is start with a family member. Maybe a family member is not feeling well. They're going through an illness. I think it's perfectly okay to call upon Jesus and say, hey, you know what? I want to practice performing a miracle. I'd like to do it with a willing family member here who's going to help me, is going to be a guinea pig for me. And then start the process with someone you trust and care about, and you know that there's no harm, no foul, okay, right? You got to start somewhere, right? And something to help us all out with this idea of claiming our ability to accept this ability that's within us and who we are, I created Claiming Your Miracles meditation this weekend. Actually, I worked on it all week. I finally recorded it. Reb Dev helped me out with it. We're going to post it online for you to use. It came out really, really, really wonderful, I think. And it's a wonderful guided meditation where you eventually go meet with Jesus and you claim your entitlement to performing miracles. So go online, it's free, download it, and check it out. I'm sure you'll like it. Please let me know about that. And then the last thing I want to share, a complimentary lesson to go along with today's idea of performing miracles, is lesson 78. Let miracles replace all grievances, okay? This is a great lesson for continuing to build the key core foundation needed to perform miracles. It's because you need to remember who you truly are and who the essence of your brother is. So if you're feeling irritated by anyone, pull out your telescoping mirror and extend it. Pull that out of your toolbox and imagine putting it right behind that person that you're feeling irritated with and look in that little mirror. Are you seeing a dirty rat or are you seeing the radiant light of God shining from the core of that individual? You got to remember that, all right? You got to get judgment out of the way. Jesus explains very clearly with us in A Course in Miracles that we have the ability to perform miracles just like he did when he walked the earth. And he wants to teach us how to become miracle workers. How cool is that? So let's get out there and let's get started. We'll be working on this for a while. Happy journeys and thank you for joining with me. Take care. Have a great day. Bye-bye.